Amen. So am I. Yeah, good evening, friends. We are here in Speaker's Corner with Muslims. They only know how to abuse like Muhammad. Muhammad was the biggest abuser of all time. But Jesus Christ is not just a prophet, as lied by that stupid Muhammad, but Jesus Christ is Almighty God. Please, thank you. Jesus Christ is Almighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Jesus came down as literally God in flesh. He humbled himself, God humbled himself, and took the form of a man, only for the plan of salvation, for the sins of the whole world. Sins of the whole world! Jesus came and gave his sinless life on the cross, and he resurrected the third day, that whosoever believes in him, the resurrection of Jesus Christ is that faith that God, Jesus said in the Bible, I can take down my life and I can resurrect my life again. And that's what Jesus has done. Those who believe in Jesus Christ will not perish.
Can I ask question?
Yeah.
Because many says that Jesus is not God. So what is your answer? Jesus is not God.
Okay.
So what is your answer?
First of all, these Muslims, they only understand the filth teaching of Muhammad.
Huh? Why are you comparing? Why are you
comparing?
Why are you comparing?
Huh?
Why are you comparing this?
You look like a devil.
Because she's talking bad.
Okay, we are having freedom of speech.
Why are you so ugly for? Why
we are
so
allowed to
speak? Cool.
We are allowed to talk here.
Why are you so ugly?
So,
I can stand this because
why are you ugly? Why are you so ugly?
If it starts the case,
why are you so ugly?
Challenge her with your speech and your knowledge.
She's
don't be aggressive and rude.
Yeah.
She's an old man. Respect
him. I will tell you
what made her ugly.
Respect him.
Okay.
I respect show Muhammad.
Respect.
I don't respect
Muhammad
her.
But show is respect not the me. Prophet of the Bible. Muhammad is not at all a prophet. Muhammad is a man. A political leader he was, who took religion and he made another religion. Muhammad is not the prophet of the Bible. So my friends, Jesus Christ is literally God in flesh, who came down only for the plan of salvation, to save the mankind spiritually from sin, from eternal death, and from Satan the devil. Jesus Christ said, whosoever believes in me will not perish but have eternal life. When we explain to these Muslims that how Jesus can be God, they don't understand that. They say, oh, how God can come down to his own creation, how God can become a man. That is their understanding of the
I got question. Can Jesus save Israel? Because Israel do not believe in Jesus.
Okay. My dear friends, Israel is who? Israel is one of the sons of Abraham. One of the sons of Abraham, Jacob, and that Israel is now, it was Jacob, but God changed his name to Israel. And Israel is still important to God. God has never forgotten the Israelites, nor God has forgotten the land. It is all important to God, and God says in the Bible, in the end times I will pour out my Holy Spirit, that they will know me by my name.
In Book of Joel, yeah?
Yes. God will pour out his Holy Spirit, and everyone will know Jesus Christ as Lord, God, and Savior.
Israel religion is Judaism.
Yes.
So how can they be saved?
Okay. Israel, they say that they are waiting for a Messiah, a physical Messiah.
Yeah.
But our Jesus Christ is the real Messiah, who is God in flesh, and God always works everything in a spiritual way. So God has done the salvation plan spiritually, not just for Israelites, but for the whole world. Because of the sin, Jesus Christ came down as God in flesh. And who has done the salvation plan for the whole world?
She's talking about,
whosoever believes in
no, she's talking about
will
Israel.
Not perish, but
Israel,
have
eternal life. About Israel.
She's a liar, she's a liar.
So,
she is a liar and a liar.
So with Israel, how can, because of the moment, Israel do not believe that Jesus is the Messiah and that Jesus is the Son of God. So what will happen to Israel?
Okay. Till now, there are Israelites, Orthodox Israelites,
yeah.
Judaism, which they don't believe that Jesus is that Messiah, that yeah. Yahweh, Elohim, El Shaddai, Adonai. They don't believe that. Yeah. But my dear friends, we are the ones who know the truth. We are the branch. We are the spiritual Israelites who are grafted
yeah, Romans
with the
11.
Physical Israelites.
Yeah, Romans 11.
Yes. We have been grafted with the physical Israelites and we have the message of the true Messiah. We need to go out and reach to the Israelites and tell them that Jesus Christ is that Yahweh, the great I Am, Elohim, El Shaddai, Adonai. The great I Am, that is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ did not come to save you physically. Physically, we all are dying physically because of the sin. The punishment of sin was death. But Jesus Christ has saved us spiritually, that whosoever believes in Him will not perish, but have eternal life. Eternal life.
As I remember, in Romans 11, we Gentiles, because if we are not Jew or yeah. Israelites, we are Gentiles.
Yeah.
So we are connected to the tree, grafted in.
Yes.
But Paul warned us, let us not be boastful, because if God remove for the meantime Israel to the true vine,
yes.
They can also remove us
yes.
And return back the true vine from the branches. So what can you say about that?
Okay, you know, about the true vine.
The vine.
Yeah.
From the tree. Yeah.
According
branches.
To... Okay.
Sorry, can I just say... Oh, sorry. Okay, I don't want to come around you, but I just want to clarify. A Jew is not an Israelite, and an Israelite is not a Jew, so please, stop using the term Israelite, because a Jew is by religion. Anyone, whether you are Indian by birth, Chinese by birth, African by birth,
so who's
and
a Jew?
Just wait a minute, anyone can be converted and become a Jew.
Yes, yes.
They are not
yes.
Israelites.
Yes.
Do not conflate the two, complete the difference.
No.
So Jesus was an Israelite,
yes.
A Judahite. He was not a Jew as modern day. And
no,
the people
no, no,
today
no.
who call themselves Jews are not Israelites.
No.
Don't confuse the
yes.
two. When you understand that, people will be more clear.
Yeah.
Thank you. That's all I want
okay.
to say.
Just
don't conflate the two.
So the present day Israelites, you say, they are not the real Israelites.
They are European.
They are all mixed people living in that country. But the present, those Israelites which God chose, they were all scattered around the world. There are no more that pure Israelites. But God is bringing all of them, because God has not done away with the Jews or the Israelites. We are the spiritual Israelites, because we have accepted the Jewish Messiah.
You are a liar. Liar. You're such a shit.
It's not true.
He's talking about Israel.
No, don't toast for
him. No, he's talking about. He's not talking about the religion.
No, Israel. Be crazy.
No,
this
no,
we're
talking.
Hospital.
No, please allow it. This
no,
is
no, 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 no.
Someone, this is someone read him.
This is free speech.
I know.
We are allowed to talk to them.
No,
no,
no, no.
This,
no, no,
because,
no, no.
Why you listen to crazy people?
You can also talk there.
No, no.
Talk about
I'm sure.
Well.
I see in the hospital.
But, no, but it's...
Disabled. This disabled.
But
she was in the hospital.
Okay, continue,
what is your
badge?
What is your badge?
Okay.
No, no, no.
So, my dear friends,
let me talk, man.
Jesus Christ is that Jewish Messiah who has fulfilled all the prophecies of a Messiah in the Bible. But still, people, the present people in Israel, they don't understand that prophecies. They need to be told, and we are given the message to go and preach to them and show them the Jewish Messiah. And you know, a lot of Jewish, those who are people living in Israel, they are believing in Jesus now. They are Messianic Jews. Yeah. There are a lot of Messianic Jews. So we are happy that, you know, God is opening their hearts, giving them the heart of flesh and taking away the heart of stone and writing their laws, writing His laws in their hearts.
Because as I remember, during the last day, God will save His people, Israel, because of His promise to Abraham.
Yes.
That whoever will bless you, I will bless, and whoever curse you, I will curse. Okay. This is why people should not mess with Israel.
Yes.
They should not mess.
Yes. In the Bible,
because God
will fight.
Because if we will study, as I study, from Moses to the to First Samuel, the God is the king of the Jew. This is why when Samuel, when the people during prophet Samuel asked for the king, God was not happy. He was sad because
he was sad.
There's lightning, everything.
God said, I am your king.
Yeah, because he's the king. Yes. But because they're asking for a king, God gave them a king. The first king is Saul, which disobeyed God. Their second is King David.
Yes. Yeah. So, my point is, the point I'm making is that Jesus as Messiah, as a spiritual Messiah, has fulfilled all the prophecies of a Messiah.
Yeah.
And you need, they need to understand why atonement was needed, why Messiah has to come. They are thinking only about physical Messiah. But my dear friends, Jesus has done it, and He's coming again only to judge the whole world as Lord God Yahweh of the Old Testament.
And also,
when He was living in Egypt, after He was thrown out by the Jews in Israel, didn't He bless the Egyptians?
Egypt was always blessed because of the Israelites.
I love it.
It was always blessed.
All right.
Because of the Jews.
No, I said Jesus.
You know, wherever Abraham's sons went,
we're
that land was always blessed because of the promise God gave to Abraham.
Listen, Jesus came to Egypt, when He was thrown out of
because of the Herod.
His country of His birth.
Yeah.
When He was thrown out of there and He went to Egypt, didn't He ask God? Didn't He bless the Egyptians who care for Him, who receive Him, who look after Him, who protect Him? Didn't He bless Him?
Of course. Egyptians are made by God. Israelites are made by God. I am made by God. You are made by God.
Yeah, but the Israelites commit crime against God.
But don't forget.
Didn't they commit a crime against God?
Yes.
When
they have always disobeyed God.
No,
yes.
when they wanted to kill God.
Yeah.
They wanted to kill God.
King Herod?
No, the Israelites. It was only the crucifixion.
The crucifixion.
No, yeah, they killed God.
What I have to say, a true Jew, a true Israeli, whatever you want to call, the Bible says someone who obeys God's commandments.
Yes.
Human being.
Yes. No, we are the spiritual Israelites.
You're giving the Jews now.
Yes. The spiritual Israelites are those who keep the commandment of God and who has the testimony of Jesus Christ.
To do what
they're
doing in Palestine.
Jesus Christ as Messiah,
you shouldn't do that.
Lord God and Savior.
They're not better than anybody. They're not from God. But you're giving them support against the Palestinians.
What? I am saying to you.
What?
We're not Jews. We're African. We're not Jews.
Okay, he is to Palestine now. He's feeling sorry for Palestine.
Of course I feel sorry. Okay.
Yeah, but,
why can't I feel sorry?
Yeah, but, but one thing I will ask
you. Why can't I feel sorry? Why wouldn't
they
feel?
1 Timothy 2:4, God said, God, He wants everybody to be saved.
Yes.
Muslim, Christian, Hindus, Palestinian.
Unless they accept the Messiah, they will not be saved.
So we are not against with Palestine.
We are not against
Israel. This is why I'm asking you about Israel.
Yes.
If they will be saved.
Yes.
Because if you do not know Jesus, you will not be saved. you will not be saved.
No, even no, no. Israel, Lord Jesus, nobody can be saved.
Yeah, even
whether
Israel.
Palestine, whether
need,
Israelite, whether Jews or anybody.
Their lives to Jesus.
Without accepting the Messiah, there is no salvation.
They are so remorse to their sin.
Huh?
The Jews.
This is why we are not pro Israel.
They are not pro Philistine.
My dear, wait for the end times.
Whether you're Jew, Christian, the Bible says all Jews.
Also,
in the Bible it says.
I don't want to read no Bible.
In the Bible it says.
I don't want to read any Bible.
In the Bible it says every knee shall bow.
Revelation.
Every tongue will confess that Jesus is.
What do you know about
God.
Bible?
And also.
So don't worry about
some
those
Roman.
Jews.
No. Some Roman fellow.
I will tell something. I will
some
tell
Roman
something.
Write some story.
If you pray, you talk to God.
Some Roman fellow write
but
a
when
story.
God talks to you, read the Bible.
If you want God
talks to you, read the Bible.
What about the English
Bible? The Bible talks to you. The word of God talks to you in the Bible.
Read the Bible.
If you will not read it,
you will not know it.
Fight all the time.
Okay, brother.
You will not know the message of God.
Fight. The Quran, same thing, fight.
Do you know Christians and Muslims are fighting, they're fighting everybody. Okay. So are you telling that God tells you to fight?
Oh my God. No, that's what they're saying. They're saying that God tells them to fight.
Who?
Allahu Akbar. In Arabic. Kill.
So that is Islam.
Kill.
That is Islam
God
teaching.
Is every time they kill somebody, they
that is not from the Bible. That
my
is
friend,
not Islam.
The Christian
read
the same thing.
What Jesus said. Read what Jesus said in Matthew 5. The meek will inherit the earth. The meek. No fighters. No angry people, but the meek. Yeah, the meek.
Okay.
Romans 13. Romans 13. God. Will use
okay.
the soldier.
He is telling that they are telling Allah Akbar and killing.
Yeah.
That Allah Akbar
from God.
Is not Muslim.
It's not from God.
Allah Akbar is satanic.
John 8:44.
Allah, those who tell Allah Akbar, they are from satanic
from
cult.
Murderer is a sin.
Murderer
is a sin.
So don't tell
murderer
they are killing. Muslim.
But Christian king.
Islam.
What happened to England? England came and killed the whole of Africa.
Okay.
Lucky we have people.
Okay, tell me which country did not go through war. Tell me which country did not go through war.
No. We're not talking about countries.
No, answer. Answer it. Answer it.
Which country?
Hitler was a man.
Middle East.
Was Hitler a Christian? Those who fought.
Because he was a Christian.
He was
a bloody cross.
Was Hitler a Christian who followed Jesus Christ?
No.
That's all. So what? Having a cross on your chest, you don't become a Christian.
Of course they are Christians.
No.
Hitler was fighting for the
Christians. Okay. Most of the people think hanging a cross on the neck, they say we are Christians. Those who believe in Jesus Christ and follow the teachings of Jesus Christ is a true believer of Christ. That's it.
Okay.